Sit down. Sit down. Who is the fucking dictator? Yahnur, welcome, demons of the Zionist media and the death to the West. Today, I wish to highlight the plight of a terribly endangered group, the innocent victims of a global human tragedy, dictators. These brave leaders are suffering a daily victimization and brutality for the supposed crime of embezzling money, oppressing their people, and doing a tiny little bit of genocide. In the recent years, tyrants all over the world have fallen one by one. Saddam, Kim Jong-il, Gaddafi, and Oprah. Sanctions are crippling us. Ahmadinejad can't even afford the tie. And because of trade embargoes, he has run out of toilet paper. Last week, he had to use his own t-shirt. It was one of his favorites. It was the I Hate New York one. The fact is, we as dictators aren't all bad. While Western countries continue to ravage our planet's resources, we conserve our land and conserve it by burying thousands of opponents in single mass eco-graves. Now, thankfully, there are still some supporters of dictatorships. On behalf of my dear friend and double tennis partner, President Assad of Syria, I want to thank the United Nations for their brave inaction over Syria. 13 months and still no Security Council resolution. You guys are amazing. You have done next to nothing for the Syrian people. But remember, you can always do less. Now please, let's take some questions. Anyone from the North Korean press? I'm kidding, they don't have one. Very well, very well. Who is first? What is right? So stand up.
Maran Haruri, Global Press.
Maran Haruri, yes, please, welcome.
Admiral General and Supreme Glorious Leader of Wadia, one question if I might. How do you respond to accusations that you are the world's most wise, glorious leader?
You've got me, I have no response. Thank you for that fair and unbiased question. Thank you. Next.
Jay Stone, Post Media News.
Why don't you take your hat off? Put it back on again, so okay?
I'm sorry, Admiral General. I'd like to know what.
Where are you from?
Canada.
Well, what's it? Even more hectic than Wadia. Okay.
I'd like to know what the dictator thinks of the American film industry. Is it quite different from what you have at home?
Well, I love American films, particularly their fantasy films like Lord of the Rings or Schindler's List. Studied at the same Holocaust Denial Institute. The head of it is Mel Gibson. Okay. I'm also a fan of Sherlock Holmes. There is always a great twist at the end where they solve the case. I never see that coming. But my favorite film ever was from 1963 and features JFK in Dallas. That one. Oh, you know, please, the people stop worrying. What do you expect? There are differences between the Wadian film industry and Hollywood. People say that I am extravagant for using 20 trillion bottles of Fiji water every day to make a snow for my ski resort in the middle of the desert. But am I the person who greenlit John Carter? Believe me, there are bigger bombs than John Carter. When it comes to making films, I am a purist. I demand the highest standards. I don't rely on the dodgy CGI.
Yes, CGI.
Yeah, I know. I don't need you to say yes. Thank you. If I need 10,000 villages to be driven off a cliff, I make it happen. You are going to stand there all day?
No.
Next, next.
Lucky Jones. Georgia Strait.
Wonderful to see so many gems.
Do I need a beer?
Do you need a beer? A Because I remember you had a pretty good one.
I wish yours was better.
Listen, this is getting a little too romantic for the room. Come on.
I would like to know who are your favorite of your fellow dictators and why, please.
Well, it has been a tough year. We have lost a lot of good people, and I have lost a lot of good friends. Gaddafi, I miss you. Gaddafi, I miss you. Also, KJ, Kim Jong, Kim Jong, K-Man, Kim Jong, and of course, Chavez died last month. Oh, oops. You did not hear that from me. Okay. Chavez is fine. It's just a coincidence that he hasn't turned up for about 2 months. Okay, you cut that out or I will cut it also. And Ahmadinejad, he is still around, but he is an embarrassment. I mean, he looks like a snitch on Miami Vice. I mean, why does he not wear a tie? Does he think every day in Iran is casual Friday in WTF? What the fuck? Next question.
Kelly Calabrese. Bodyscoop.com.
Ah, Helen Calabrese. Wearing jeans.
Yeah, I got
you. You are radical.
What are your...
You are on a very show.
I am.
Have your legs chopped off? Or? Let's depend on your next question. We'll see. I'm joking.
What are your pop culture guilty pleasures?
Bob culture.
Pop culture.
Yes. When I am not watching my people, I am glued to my couch watching the satellite television. And my favorite shows are Wadiyan. We have our version of Two and a Half Men. It used to be called Three Men, but one of them tried to steal a grapefruit. Also, I love the TV program 24. You have it here? But we play it backwards, so it has a happy ending. And Laverne and Shirley, I like it. It's good fun. You know, and it's not crude, which I hate. I can show it to any one of my 1,600 children and not worry about it. All of them are boys. A total coincidence. And we have Wadi and Idol, in which the people build a massive statue of me. Well, are you not going to stand there? Well, you just going to stand there for the rest? Stop giggling. I don't like it. Next.
Ethan Sachs, New York Daily News. Good afternoon,
you're awesome. Who wants to share it? We're not cheering for me. Not cheering for Ethan Sachs from New York News.
Good afternoon, Your Excellence. I want to ask which U.S. presidential candidate would you endorse?
Oh, the U.S. Well, I would say Santorum, despite his liberal views. But since he is out of the running, I don't know. In terms of policies, I would have to say the Republicans, if they could only become a little less extreme. I mean, there are some real double standards. You know, what people call genocide in my country is called the judicial system in Texas. But in terms of getting into power in America, I would have to support the Democrats. If they can enable a Kenyan to become president, then why not Wadid? But if it was the money that I was giving, I support and I give my full support to Mitchell Romney. He has the makings of a great dictator. He is incredibly wealthy, but pays no taxes. And it's not much of a leap to go from firing people to firing squirts. And from putting pets on the top of a car to putting political antecedents on the top of them. He taught me how to do that. Please.
Heidi Patalani, Metro.
Heidi Patalani. But the last word, who cares? It's so charming you have these female journalists here. It's like putting a dog on roller skates. It means nothing to them, but it's adorable for us.
Yes, please speak.
Thank
you. You've had much sorrow in your life, your mother dying in childbirth, and I think all six of your brothers died accidentally. So how do you deal with these traumas?
Yes, my mother died in childbirth of strangulation. My father also died in a tragic hunting accident when he was accidentally hit by 97 stray bullets. And he also had a terrible allergy. He was allergic to grenades. And my uncle is dying in a helicopter crash later on today. It will be very sad. Bless, next.
Ben Leons, extra.
Ben Leons. With her, you're...
Good afternoon, Joe.
Are you a Zionist?
No, I'm a New Yorker.
You're a New Yorker?
What do you have to say?
I am Benjamin.
Only Benjamin when I'm in trouble with my mother. What would you say to your critics out there?
Don't worry, your mother, you know, how is she, your mother?
My mother's doing well, thank you.
Correct, she is. Where is she now?
She's in New York City, she's doing fine.
Incorrect.
Can I ask a question, Supreme Leader?
Okay, go.
What would you have to say to your critics out there who label you a tyrant?
I would say thank you. Also, could you please give me the names and addresses of the so-called critics and their routes to and from work? I'd like to give them a magnetic gift in the touches to the underneath of the car.
Casey Dolan, MSNBC.
MSNBC. Wait a minute, I think I own 30% of MSNBC.
I think you might. Admiral General, I imagine you're...
Why are you all women? What did you do to the men?
I think there's some. I imagine you're under constant threat of danger. Who do you keep close to you? Who do you
trust? Quiet, Baghdad, please. Or I will execute you. That has nothing to do with me.
I imagine you're under constant threat of danger. Who do you keep close to you? Who do you trust?
I have 25 female virgin guards who protect me at all times. I know they are virgins because I have their virginity checked every night by the head of my penis. There is no danger of that with you. Okay, please. Oh, you are so all the time worrying about everybody's feelings. You fucking Americans. Yeah, is he okay? Is they okay? You can't ever do anything or say anything. Everything forbidden in this country. Please, carry on. Relax. You got to relax. Okay. Say with everyone. No. It was just helping me. Okay, go ahead.
Melissa Unger, WNUE-TV.
Hi, Your Excellency. I have a quick question.
Oh, yes, please. Don't worry. Don't worry.
Serious question here. How do
you... Of course it's serious.
How do you plan to ensure that democracy will never, ever take over your country? And why do you feel that you will succeed when so many other dictators have failed?
Well, my people, they don't want the democracy. They love me, and I have many signed confessions to that effect. I am like a father to my people, quite literally to about 1,800 of them. Besides, our version of government is much more efficient than yours. Democracy is the worst. Endless talking, and everyone's vote counts, no matter how black or crippled or female you are. Next, please.
Next, Natasha Asrani, Reuters.
They are obedient but stupid, I suppose. You must look at me, stop looking at the girls. They aren't interested in you, believe me.
So, General, is it true or just a rumor that you've been banned from British TV?
Oh, yes, it's true. The BBC has issued sanctions against me. They have banned me from all the BBC channels and also the BBC radio. It's true. Look, nobody is a bigger fan of state-sponsored censorship. Sorry, I have something in my mouth. Don't worry. Not what you're thinking. Look, nobody is a bigger fan of the state-sponsored censorship than me, but the BBC took it too far. All I wanted to do on the BBC was use their airwaves to promote my anti-West, anti-Zionist platform and quell those nasty rumors about the Holocaust. I guess no good deed goes unpunished. I guess that joke does not go down that well in New York. That one was written by Ahmadinejad. No, carry on.
Alicia Guarales, E.
Hi, Your Excellency.
Hello. Ah, you are a sub-Saharan.
Something like that.
Oh, yes, wonderful.
All right, so you've been with so many celebrities, but who's the one that got away, the one you really want to be with?
The one who I want to be with. Yeah. Where are you from?
From E! Entertainment.
From E! But in the country.
From California originally.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
The short trip to Wadia. And listen, they never get away. They try, but without their passports, it is difficult. Sure, maybe they hop the wall of my private disco, but there is no escape from the desert. Within hours, they shrivel up till they look like a mugshot of Lindsay Lohan.
Oh. I have a couple more questions. So you heard your girl Megan Fox is pregnant. Did you say congratulations to her?
Yes, congratulations to her. There are rumors that I am the father. But this is literally impossible. It would be the first ever anal conception. And if she is pregnant, then so is Heidi Klum and also Donald Trump. He does anything for money.
Your Excellency, you hear about rulers flying in entertainers to perform at events all the time. Who would you fly in and why?
Well, a number of years ago, I had Tupac Shakur. He played at my birthday party. And all the time, he was telling me, put your hands in the air and wave them around like you just don't care. How dare he order me what to do with my hands? So in the end, I had to get rid of him. Notorious B.I.G., he was also playing. He ended up eating half of the buffet. It was 80 euros per head, it cost me a fortune, so the big answer.
And here's my final question. You're visiting our lovely city.
But I would say back to your other thing. Yeah. I have made a beautiful love and also sex activity with many of your celebrities, Britney Spears, Beyonce, and Kim Kardashian. She is a very nice girl, but unbelievably hairy. When I pulled her panties down, I thought I was looking in the mirror.
You better apologize to Kim. You know she's on our network. You gotta
keep her safe. I am a dictator. You think I am worried about the Persian girl with sisters?
Here's my final question. Where do you like
I will have Ahmadinejad recall her and her family back to Iraq.
What do you like to do when you're in New York? What are some of your
favorite places? Are you fanning yourself? You're okay?
I'm okay.
Relax. It's okay.
What are your favorite things to do in New York City?
As far as the tourist sites, I love to see the Empire State Building and the Statue of Liberty, and also the Hotel Curtain where Dominic Strauss-Kahn wiped his bilboa after doing a sex activity with that chambermaid. But while I'm here, I am helping my friends by outdoing the sanctions that are put on them. Buying stuff for all the other dictators that are banned from coming here. I went to Hermes and bought some luggage. I went to Prada and bought 14 suits and 2 showgirls. And I bought 20% of Citibank. But while I'm here as well, I am buying stuff for Kim Jong-un. You know Kim Jong-un, the son of Kim Jong-il. He is crazy about your Krispy Kremes. He has asked me to get him 20,000 crates. He loves to stuff them in his mouth 5 at a time. That is why he always looks like he is holding in a fart.
Thank you for visiting our city.
Oh, please, thank you. Wonderful. Very nice. Not bad, really nice. Please.
Next movie, Brian Heldman.
Hello, Supreme Leader.
Urdu. Brian, what is your name?
Brian Heldman. Yes, I'm a Jew. What did you think?
You are putting me in a very difficult.
It's not the first
I suppose I should not be surprised. We We are in New York with the media, and yet I am going to find this out to answer your question. Enjoy, I don't have a problem with you.
All right, great.
It's just descendants of the tribe of Moses.
General Alladin, what did you think of the Hunger Games, and are you considering instituting such an event in Wadia?
What is the point? North Korea has done it literally. Now Kim Jong-un is doing his own version of The Biggest Loser. 7 billion people are competing to see who can lose the most weight. Any more juicy? By the way, are there any more juicy? Just, I want to know. Put your hands up. Do we have enough sacks? Okay, no problem. Welcome. Everybody is my friend.
Yesenia Brilevskaya, film.riu.
Oh, now you sound like a non-Jew.
And Russian.
Better.
So my question is, given the great history of close and mutually beneficial relationship between Wadia and Russia, is there any practice in contemporary Russia you would like to introduce in your country?
I love your government's policy of taking your shirt off for state-sponsored events. Every time I turn on the television, there is a picture of Putin half-naked. I got his Christmas calendar this year, and he is topless in every month. June, he was bench-pressing a protester. Angela Merkel sent out a topless calendar as well. I wanted to pop my eyes off. Another thing Russia does amazingly well is turning sushi and making it become radioactive. please, and congratulations to your dictator for his new term.
Belinda Johnson, Veronica Magazine.
Oh. I have a question for you.
Yes, please.
Why do women get turned on by men in uniform?
What? Say that again.
Why do women get
Where are you from?
From Holland.
Oh, from Holland. Very flat. Easy to obey.
Why do women get turned on by men in uniform so much? And why is notorious Don Galliano the one to design yours?
Well, I love Galliano. Say what you want about his avant-garde style and fashion approach, but the guy does hate Jews. And women like a man in uniform because when they see a man in uniform, they know there is a chance they could be released. Please, welcome.
Nadia, neophyte, ITM.
Hey! Hey!
Idiots. I mean, it's no surprise that I, you know, tortured them. They're, what do you expect with this women?
What Hollywood celebrity do you have the most in common with?
Are you from Australia?
No, South Africa.
Ah, okay, but they have a good history as well. What are you doing? What?
We do now.
Yeah, of course you do. Yeah, we have. Okay, well, ask your question again.
What Hollywood celebrity do you have the most in common with?
Oh, it has to be Mela Gibson. In fact, recently in Wadia, we made him our public relations expert. Although he has said some pretty offensive things recently, like saying that he would work with Jews, we have made him the head of our Museum of Intolerance. I also have a lot in common with George Clooney. We are both the champions of equality. You know, in my country, women have the same rights as men. Absolutely not. And there is a shameful statistic that only one in four Wadian women can read. I am trying to change that statistic and make it 1 in 100. Please.
Eduardo Light, Playboy Brazil.
Ah, Playboy. You know, often I look through your magazines and then I pick one and fly her over. It is a very efficient catalog for me.
We do the same thing.
Well, you do the same thing at the magazine.
Yes. Well, we were
finally a man.
Yes. In Brazil, we had a long period of dictatorship.
Yes, congratulations.
Yes, but most Brazilians dislike that period very much.
What?
We don't like it. Why do you think dictatorship should still be an option of government? And would you like to invade us?
Well, I have already invaded a small portion of Brazil, the Malawach of Gisele Bündchen. I plan on launching a tiny missile into Adriana Lima. But yes, you must go back to dictatorships. It's the way forward, democracy. Really, you don't get anything done. Look at this country. And Obama always trying to do stuff, and nothing gets done. Better to have one guy doing the wrong thing, but at least getting it done. Then you can complain. Next.
Thank you. Linda Flood, Duggins, my heater.
Linda Flood. No rush, Linda.
Swedish.
You are Swedish.
Yes.
I admire your face.
Great
program,
yes.
Not very much, I was referring to
what do you think about what do you think about the Arab Spring and the result of it?
The Arab Spring is one of the great tragedies of our time. First Mubarak is shown the door, now he and his mistresses must make do with the measly $1 billion he stole. Now how are they supposed to eat out and how are they supposed to go on vacation? And then they got a poor old Muma. He and I were signed up to rent Miranda KF for next month, and now he's gone, and I'm not going to get my deposit back. And as for Assad, he has had a terrible time, you know, what's going on there, and also having contracted HIV. Both him, his wife, and his personal trainer are obviously clearly upset about it. You know, it's not the death sentence it used to be, but we'll see. Thank you, Sweden. Next.
Frank Seiring, Bild and Sonntag.
No. How are you, sir?
Yeah, very well. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you.
Okay, enough about you.
What's that?
From where?
Germany.
Ah, from Germany. Wonderful. Inspirational back.
Are you a more dangerous dictator than Hitler ever was? And if so, how?
Sorry, repeat?
Are you a more dangerous dictator than Hitler ever was? And if so, how?
Wow. I mean, wow. Sorry, I'm getting a little choked up. I mean, it's one thing to be called Hitler-esque, but to be in the same discussion, in the same line as Hitler, wow, I feel like I finally made it. You know, my father actually knew Adolf, and you're going to find this hard to believe, but he barely had a single good word to say about him. I remember him telling me that man was a terrible, terrible, terrible charades player. All the time cheating. Please, welcome. Next.
No more.
Yeah, okay. For who are you? From here?
Yes.
How do you want to?
Can I do it?
I can't do sex activity
no,
now.
No, one.
Everyone, okay, fine, we do it.
Why did you dump the ashes on my colleague Ryan Seacrest? I don't know this.
Ryan Seacrest, well, it's not the first time that he has had an Asian man poured all over his chest. The reality is, you know, I was showing him that it was from South Korea. The arm was made from South Korea. I lifted it up and then it accidentally fell on him. But you know, they were not his ashes. His son, Kim Jong-un, he is so fat, he looks like he swallowed his father. And that is because he actually did. You know, so it was the remains of the barbecue. But now you know that jacket is the property of North Korea. So Seacrest better give it back. The missile they sent over recently in North Korea, it was aimed at the E Studios. So give it back. Yes, please. No.
Oh.
Yes, I just have a little. Standing here, hey, I don't like to see it. Yeah. What do you want?
My question is actually I have two questions.
Did you just come up here to show me your billboard? Is this why you flew all the way from Israel? You know where we are, we live, my Wadir is 12,000 miles directly as the Scud flies from Israel.
Well, my question is sort of related. We have elections in 4 months in Israel, and would you consider running for president in Israel?
Would I consider? Yes, the first thing I would do would be to destroy Israel. I don't know whether I would get many votes. You want to show your people to the rest of the...
Show them afterwards. My second question is...
What, you have a second question? You see, this is why people don't like the Israelis. You know, it's not even on the list. He shows me his dick and then he asking two questions.
He asked four questions.
Who asked four questions?
The E-channel.
He is the E-channel is... because I want to do sex activity with her. Although if you did it with me, believe me, it would be painless for me. Okay.
If Benjamin Netanyahu, Prime Minister, and Ahmadinejad would have a fist fight, who do you think would win?
Who would win between Netanyahu and Ahmadinejad?
Yes.
Well, I think Ahmadinejad. He would nuke Netanyahu. Of course, his nuclear program is entirely for peaceful purposes. Okay, what are you going to do? Stand up there. No, don't wave goodbye to me. We have friends. Okay, all right. Thank you. Death to the West. Our planes, enjoy yourselves and enjoy. We have Rolexes here for you. You may enjoy the prostitutes we brought in or the boys, if you like, if you're from Canada. Enjoy. And as long as you write good reviews, your families will be released. Enjoy and have luck. Death to the West. Thank you.